Hi Sunil, how are you?
I am Purushottam, mathematics teacher, JPHS RVR.
Okay, Nana. Here, 8.3, first question. This is DEF. Sir, DEF. All the midpoints of sides DC, AE, and AB. Okay, of triangle ABC. Find the ratio of areas of when I join this triangle, we get DEF triangle and ABC triangle. But already earlier in the chapter 8.1 exercise, I think maybe third question I think. When you join the midpoints, that line is exactly parallel to the third side according the basic converse of basic proportionality. How is A by MB is equal to 1 and AE by EC is equal to also 1 because this is the midpoint, no? So AF by FB is equal to AE by EC. So that what happened? According to the converse of basic proportionality, FE is parallel to BC. This is we know already. What we know, Nana? If any triangle, when we join midpoints of any two sides, is parallel to third side and also it is half of the third side. It is half of the third side means FE is equal to half of BC. Already we learned in 9th class. And the same way when I join FD, that FD also half of AC. We know already. If we join ED, that ED is parallel to AB also and half of AB also. So remember these points and go for problem. Okay, Nana? Clear? Got a simple question. Easily we can find out. Okay, Nana? See ya. How to find? First, in triangle ABC, sir, F, E are midpoints of which we sign on AB and AC. So, we can write as FE is parallel to BC and at the same time and FE is half of BC. Okay, remember these points. Okay, similarly FD is parallel to AC and FD is equal to half of AC. That is like that remaining. What is that next one? So DE also parallel to AB and DE is equal to half of AB. Okay, Nana? Remember these points. Okay, now I am going to compare. I am taking it, this is the quadrilateral. The quadrilateral name is FDCE. Quadrilateral FDCE. In quadrilateral FDCE, FE is parallel to DC. DC means nothing but DC. FE is parallel to DC and FD is parallel to EC. FD is parallel to EC. So what happened then? So what will FDVCE is a parallelogram. Okay? Parallelogram. Otherwise you do, if two lines are parallel and transversal line, then alternate angles are equal. Just go through that method also, no problem. It is a parallelogram so that angle F is equal to angle C. That all I am writing on angle EFD. Angle EFD is equal to angle ECD. Why ECD? Because opposite angles are always equal in a parallelogram. Okay, is it clear? Understood? At the same way, this is also the parallelogram. Similarly, quadrilateral FEDB is also a parallelogram. Sir, when it is parallelogram, their angle E is equal to angle B. That means angle FED, angle FED is equal to angle B. This is the first equation, this is the second. Okay, now I am going to compare this small triangle and this biggest triangle. In triangle ABC, comma, in triangle DABC, B is equal to E, no? B is equal to E, that's why DEF. Instead of DFE, written as DEF. So, from first and second equation, that satisfies AA similarity criteria. AA similarity criteria. So that triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF. Understand this is? ABC is similar to triangle DEF. When these two triangles are similar, already we have one method. What is that? If two triangles are similar, the ratio of areas of two similar triangles is equal to ratio of squares of corresponding sides or corresponding altitudes or corresponding medians or corresponding angle bisectors. This much of information is there for us. So what? If these two triangles are similar, that point I am going to write. What is that? You write it. What is that? A ratio of areas of two similar triangles is equal to ratio of squares of corresponding sides. That only I am writing, sir. Yeah. Triangle ABC. Area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DEF is equal to ratio of squares of the corresponding triangle ABC, basis BC, example BC square is equal to FE square, EF square or FE square. Okay, so what happened? Sir, so here I am writing as triangle ABC by triangle DEF is equal to BC square as it is generating by instead of EF square, means FE square, FE or EF, otherwise I am writing here FE only, FE square only. Okay, instead of FE, you can write as half BC whole square. Then what happened? Triangle ABC by triangle DEF is equal to, we get BC square by BC square by 4. That 4 we can write as BC square cancel, we get 4 is to 1. So ABC is to DEF is equal to, we get 4 is to 1. Means biggest triangle 4 parts means the smallest triangle is 1. This is the method to do the problem. Have you understand and see properly? Check. Note it and practice one or two times. Very easily we can understand. Thank you, children.